Just as we're all paying more attention to the food that we eat, pet owners are keeping a closer eye on the foods that they're buying for their pets. But just because a marketer says a food is healthy doesn't mean it is. And that is why two entrepreneurs, both dog lovers from Brooklyn, New York, got the bright idea to start a company aiming specifically to keep your dog healthier. For 2 years, Jada suffered with stomach issues. Her owner, Brett Podolsky, tried all kinds of foods, from kibbles to cans, and freeze-dried to raw. But he was constantly running home to check on Jada.
I felt so bad for her. It was like a heartbreaking time period.
In 2014, a vet suggested home cooking. Human food, beef and vegetables. Jonathan Regev, that's his dog, Buddy, roomed with Podolsky at the time.
I was like, what are you doing? He's like, I'm cooking for Jada. And I just thought he was insane. I'd never seen anybody cooking for their dog before.
It was like magic. All of her symptoms disappeared.
Unable to find a product on the market using the USDA's standards for human food, Podolsky and Regev kept cooking and began researching. They found stories linking cancers in pets to food, companies focused on cost efficiency, and products meeting only bare minimum standards.
Nothing commercial was going to be fed to my dog ever again.
Dogs need what's known as a complete and balanced diet, with more vitamins and nutrients than they get from human food alone. So Podolsky and Regev created a mix and tested samples at a lab until they got the farmer's dog. Launching in late summer 2014, it's frozen and shipped to arrive days after it's cooked.
So this one's turkey, broccoli, parsnips, carrots. And then the vitamin and mineral mix.
It's human grade with no preservatives. And yes, they've both eaten it.
Somebody was like, when was the last time you ate it? And I was feeding Jada and I was just like, just take a bite.
We had a Thanksgiving dinner with the team and our head of engineering put the turkey recipe inside of these empanadas and didn't tell anybody.
Dr. Carly Fox at the Animal Medical Center in New York says she usually recommends commercially available food as long as it's complete and balanced. So is freshly made human food better? She says maybe.
It is beneficial for a pet to eat human grade food if it's something that is available to you and it's something that you're able to provide to your pet. I think it's something that you should absolutely discuss with your veterinarian.
Costs depend on the size of a dog, averaging about $29 a week. The farmer's dog hit the market just as American spending on pet food began trending up, almost $30 billion in 2018, up more than 30% in 4 years. For 2 years, the farmer's dog rented startup spaces, cooking alongside startups making human food products. Since then, Podolsky and Regev found a commercial manufacturer using USDA human food standards. And the pair say they're now shipping more than 1 million meals a month.
When people think about dog food and dog food that they want to invest in to keep their dog healthier, that food will look like food and it won't be a brown ball.
This is not just a sick dog thing. This is an every dog thing. We wanted a company whose entire focus was making dogs healthy.
And their customers are buying into the idea that preservatives aren't great for humans, and so they probably aren't great for animals either.